Hello and welcome to New Mexico's Naturopathic Medical Show. I'm Dr. Wendy Van Dilla, naturopathic physician and your host. In the studio today with me is Dr. Bill Wolfe, a holistic biological dentist here in Santa Fe and also in Albuquerque, New Mexico. So welcome back to the show, Dr. Bill Wolfe.
Oh, thank you, Wendy.
And we're going to continue our conversation from the last show, talking about how important holistic dentistry is to our whole body health and the interconnectedness between our teeth and our whole body. So we've got a number of subjects to cover that we started in the first segment, and we'll continue.
Yes.
So could you explain a little bit more about the chart that has been up?
This is the chart that was developed by Dr. Voll in 1953, so it's not new knowledge. And it's demonstrating the energetic relationships of the teeth to the corresponding organs. The acupuncture meridians run through your head, and the teeth can influence the flow of that energy meridian. If you have decay in the tooth, periodontal disease, a bio-incompatible dental restoration, infected dead teeth, even a bite problem can block the energetics to distant areas.
And that affects the health of the
yes,
organs in our body and our structures.
Your highest health to keep your mouth healthy.
And we've got, our audience will be able to see a more simple version than the chart that we have here on the set with
yes.
us.
Yes, that's the one that's in Shirley MacLaine's book, Saging While Aging.
Saging While
back.
Aging.
She was fascinated with the chart, and I simplified this chart for her readers. And it demonstrates there how which teeth are large intestine teeth, stomach teeth, liver teeth, pancreas teeth, etc.
And this a version of this chart is used by holistic dentists.
Yes. Now, this is German acupuncture, not Oriental acupuncture. And that's what I studied with Dr. Voll when he developed electroacupuncture according to Voll, EAV.
And how do you use this chart in your practice?
We'll determine if people's they have a total health issue, and I'm a dental detective.
Mm-hmm.
I'm trying to determine what dental issues might be contributing or suppressing their progression to health. In other words, if that tooth is a dental focus, energetic focus on the meridian, if there's a biomechanical imbalance, if it's a biocompatibility issue of materials, certainly periodontal disease, bacteria in the mouth are very influencing on your total health because they get into the bloodstream, go throughout the body, and can cause very serious diseases. The mouth is the dirtiest place in the body, bacteria-wise, and it's really need to keep your mouth clean to be as healthy as you want to be.
A human bite is more dangerous than an animal bite.
Yes, exactly. In emergency rooms, I'm told they treat human bites with much more severity than a dog bite.
So the tools you have as a holistic dentist vary from a conventional dentist. So you have this chart as part of your dental detectives
yes.
detective work. And then what other tools do you use that are unique?
Well, to give patients information, because all I'm doing is educating the patient. The patient makes the decisions based on informed consent, which they haven't had before because they still think a silver filling is a silver filling. When really a silver amalgam filling is 50% mercury, it's only 30% silver, 10 zinc and copper, and people are very surprised many times to find out there's number one mercury in the tooth, and it is the predominant ingredient. Now we can demonstrate that with the mercury vapor tester, and we'll have a patient come up, and I'll show you how much vapor we can get out of one filling.
That sounds great.
Let me do a little preparatory work about mm-hmm. this instrument. This instrument was developed for mining, to find gold, because wherever you, I am told, you find mercury vapor in a mine, chances are that that's where the gold vein is. And I talked to the geologist that developed this instrument, John McNerney, in Jerome, Arizona. I talked to him many in the early 80s, and he told me this, that it was developed for mining, and then the U.S. Navy bought 200 of them for the submarines, because if you have a mercury leak in a switch or pressure gauge in a deep sealed container, that would be disastrous for everyone.
Oh, yeah.
So they really set him on track here with looking at this instrument as much more than just mining, but as an industrial unit. And now I understand public service companies all over the country have them to check switches and gauges, etc. And OSHA, if they walk into your plant and find that you have more than 50 micrograms per cubic meter of air, they can fine you $10,000 and close your plant down.
Wow.
The interesting thing is we find that many times out of one tooth.
And
they could close your mouth down and fine you $10,000.
So there's a real disconnect in our culture about the danger of mercury.
Yes.
Exactly. That in some instances it's very, we understand that's it's a huge problem, but how does it not be a problem in dentistry?
Well, in 1840, you used to have to sign a pledge to be a member of the American Society of Dental Surgeons that you would not place mercury fillings.
So it was known back in the 1800s,
exactly,
that using mercury
fact,
in our mouth.
Do you know where the word quack came from?
Nowhere.
Doctors that are quacks?
Where?
Other than you?
Other than naturopathic physicians.
And me. That the quacksilver is the name for mercury in the Scandinavian countries.
Oh, I thought it was quicksilver.
Quacksilver. Silver. S-I-L-B-E-R. And the treatment for syphilis a couple of centuries ago, mm-hmm, was an immersion in a mercury bath.
Oh, my goodness. Yes.
And
yes,
if it didn't kill the patient and killed the spirochete organisms first, then mm-hmm, that was a success. Anyway, the doctors that performed that procedure were called quacks.
Wow.
Of course, the other major reference to mercury inadvertently was through Lewis Carroll's book, Mad as a Hatter, character in Alice in Wonderland.
Mm-hmm.
That the Hatters worked the felt hats in Danbury, Connecticut with mm-hmm, mercury, and they were mad as a hatter. They also had something called the Danbury Shakes, which was peripheral neuropathies, which is a classic mercury heavy metal toxicity.
So dentists that still use mercury are the mad hatters of our culture.
I've known numerous dentists that have had peripheral neuropathies, yes.
And damage.
Yes, and damage, and mercury toxicity. And I've known dentists that have had to get out of dentistry because of mercury toxicity. And I myself was mercury toxic, and that's how I got into being a mercury-free dentist. I was very ill in the 70s, had a tumor. And after my surgery, I was found to be very mercury toxic, had mercury vapor coming out of my skin that was measured from one of these instruments.
Yikes.
And I bought one of these instruments and started measuring people's mouths in the early 80s and writing letters to OSHA and the FDA how much mercury reading I was getting out of fillings.
Well, I know there's a big political movement to educate the public, educate our political structures that this is a huge problem and needs to be addressed.
Well, it is, and the FDA is being confronted by Citizens for Health right now about prove it safety,
and,
which has never been proven.
You've written a lot of articles for a publication that used to be called, I think, Natural Living, and now it's called Truly Alive.
Yes.
And I really appreciate all the articles that you've written. So these are accessible in different publications.
And on my website, drwolfe.com.
Okay,
you've got some past articles. Yes.
And you talk about some legislation that's a town, Spring Hill, that banded together to get a crematory from being established in their community because...
No, there are many ways to be exposed to mercury besides fillings. You know, in products, thimerosal issue in vaccines, mm-hmm, coal, fired power plants, crematories when bodies are cremated. There's a large amount of mercury vapor.
So the fillings in people's mouths,
yes,
when their bodies are cremated, gets mm-hmm, released into our atmosphere.
Yes.
And it was found that it was especially affecting children's health.
Yes.
And the community said, we don't want this damaging our children. And this is a recent victory in this whole field.
Some towns are choosing to be mercury-free towns. So that's very good to hear. It needs to come from the citizens.
Yes, yes.
From patients that have experienced.
There's an organization, Consumers for Dental Choice, and Charles Brown.
Yes, he's the attorney for Consumers for Dental Choice. He used to be Consumers for Dental Health.
He's been working diligently for quite a while.
Yes, he's confronting the FDA right now. Yes. So let's measure some mercury vapor.
Excellent.
So Madonna, would you come up? So what we're going to do is just take a sampling, a 10-second sampling of air that the air is sucked into this instrument and goes over a gold film analyzer, and it actually counts the molecules of mercury. So it's quite a sophisticated instrument.
So it can detect a very fine amount.
Yes.
So molecules.
So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to pick this tooth on the lower right.
So have you been chewing gum, Madonna?
She chewed
okay.
gum.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so that releases.
You got 148, knowing that 50 is the standard, the threshold limit value for an industrial standard, 50 micrograms per cubic meter of air.
So 50 is
cubic meter of air. 50 is the threshold top. She has 148 out of one tooth.
Wow.
So she's three times over industrial standards that OSHA would fine her and close her mouth down if she were in industry. But magically.
So if you were in a submarine, that submarine would be in the shop.
Okay, now.
Okay, so this is just one tooth that's getting measured from mercury vapor, which is actually one of the more dangerous things about having mercury in our mouth.
Okay, now this is 39, so there is quite a variation.
And was there a big size difference between those two fillings?
No, they were the same size. One was just on one side of the mouth, and one was on the other side of the mouth.
And they're the same age.
And they're the same age. So let's try another one over here.
So would the one with more mercury...
See, this was the largest one, and it has 19.
19? Wow.
Now, the World Health Organization has said there is no minimum amount of mercury that can be considered safe.
That is safe. So even the ones that have the, quote, lower reading.
Well, you add them all together. I had 19 to 39 to 140, and
that's a lot.
What her, and she still has numerous other mercury fillings here.
And you are breathing that mercury?
It's vaporizing as she sits here and breathing. And then when she eats a low pH salad dressing, drinks hot coffee, chews gum, it causes more vaporization.
And that vapor goes right into our nervous system and our brain, right? Easily absorbed.
It's, and remember the letter from OSHA that the inhalation, absorption, and ingestion of the roots, that when I wrote OSHA in the 80s and told them what readings I was getting out of people's mouths, they were quite aware of the intraoral and the extraoral mercury are the same. This is 219.
Ooh, that's the most one. So
that's
that was
the winner on the top. How old do you think these fillings are?
5 years. I had all of my mercury replaced with new mercury.
So, ouch. So you worked with a dentist that was not aware of the problem and replaced mercury with mercury fillings.
Now let's also test what we were speaking of in the last program about the electrogalvanism of dissimilar metals. In other words, every mercury filling is a battery because it has mercury, silver, tin, zinc, copper, and every one of those ingredients is very electroconductive. So let's just see what kind of readings that we get off of these fillings.
So you're grounding her with that hook?
And yes.
Then, and then touching the probe to a tooth with metal
exactly.
in it. And looking for the reading.
Now we get a negative 8. Now this is microamps.
Mm-hmm. And what would be
normal? Well, there is no normal because it's not considered a problem by the American Dental Association. But if we are an electrical being with a physical body. And this is a negative 5 on this other tooth. And we have all the energetics of the cell membrane potential. We've got EEG, EKG, all the meridians running through the area. To have aberrant current flying around our mouth is very questionable. This is a negative 13 over here.
So our brain, our nervous system, our heartbeat all run on electrical currents.
And it's a negative 2. So she's got some negatives all over her mouth.
Did you test the mercury fillings? The tooth that has the mercury fillings that you just read?
They're all mercury fillings. And what we're testing, this has nothing to do with mercury. This has everything to do with dissimilar metals. In other words, the electrogalvanism of the higher noble to the lesser noble metals creates a current flow, and there's an electromagnetic field around that current flow.
Okay.
So this is why I'm not using metals anymore. It's because I don't want to have the patient to have to deal with the current flow in their mouth. I've been mercury-free since the 70s, but now I'm metal-free. No. And the technology in dentistry has gotten to the point that we don't need to be doing metals anymore. So we can create dentistry that is very, where is that chart that we have? That is very beautiful and is very biocompatible at the same time. So you can see the difference between a mercury amalgam filling and the same teeth restored with the composite ceramics.
That's a huge difference. I mean, the metal fillings are ugly and they're dangerous.
So this is the issue at hand is maybe when people's immune systems were, as when you're 25 and we're going to live forever and conquer the world, remember that we could withstand some of these environmental insults that we place our body in. But as we get older and hopefully develop a little more wisdom, and the adaptive capacity of our immune system is not willing to put up with things like we used to. So to be as healthy as we want to be, we really need to look at the mouth. Keep it clean. Keep the energetic interference field down. Make sure that we have biocompatible materials that are placed, and it's all the same. And that we have a bite balanced so that when we close, our strength is up.
While Madonna's still up here on stage with us, would you show the muscle testing?
Certainly.
That is an easy tool that you use in your office.
We're just asking the body questions. The body will speak to us. It just doesn't speak English. It speaks energy. It's all in asking the right question, the energy question. So teeth apart, be strong. Okay, now does energy flow is always the question, see? Energy flows quite well. And even down the back. Good. Now close down. Now, see the difference. Now,
wow.
Try to be as strong as you can. Right down.
So one finger.
So every time she swallows, every 45 seconds, her muscle tone is depleted. And it's not just her jaw, but it's all the way down her back. So it's not just a localized problem.
So is the issue in her mouth affecting?
Well, now we could use the demagnetizer and find that out.
Mm-hmm.
We could also just erase the disturbance field so that the meridians flow, because what we have here is a disturbance of the meridians. And if we just get the meridians to flow so that now she's strong in this area, then she'll be strong here too. So I feel that she has a meridian congestion. She has an energetic focus on the meridians from her teeth.
And by doing that erasing, how long does that last?
Well, it'll just last about 30 seconds.
So that's...
You know, it's just something that, it's a question you're asking. You're just stimulating the acupuncture meridians that are now suppressed. And then we find out how would the rest of the body feel if the meridians were fully flowing. Now, we could also do the same thing. Okay, take the part. Now, it just lasts about 30 seconds. So, you know, now close down.
So this is,
see, she's weakened again.
It's giving you information.
Yes, exactly. And
it's
we
not
just,
a treatment.
Right. Now, let's just do this. Let's just demagnetize this area. In other words, whenever you have a current flow, you have an electromagnetic field around the current flow. And if we can reduce the electromagnetic field, then we can also reduce the current flow just for a moment.
So is part of this to convince your patients that this is really important?
Well, for me too, because if she had a TMJ bite problem, I want to know how much of her issue when she gets weak is a biomechanical imbalance and how much is just dissimilar metals touching each other. Open. Be strong. Okay, now close.
So this is a diagnostic tool.
Mm-hmm. See, so with her teeth together, now she has a current flow that has been diminished so that the meridians are flowing. Okay, before she had a disturbance field and the meridians were blocked. I demagnetized the disturbance field and now the meridian's flowing. So it's just a simple question to ask, how would she be without metal fillings? And the answer is you'd be quite stronger.
Great.
Thank you, Madonna.
Thank you, Madonna.
You know, I know your cameraman over here has a tooth problem. Is there any chance we could get him over here and test him? Let's do that.
Great. Get Mr. Harvey up here and do some testing. Thank you.
So, obviously, we won't be using that camera. All right, why don't we stand over here, Harvey?
He's a bit taller than our last two guests.
Okay, so let's just find out where you are in the clear. Can I test the shoulder
here?
Sure. Yeah. Okay, open big. Be strong. You're a strong fella. Okay, now take your energy detection finger. Touch a tooth we think is pretty healthy. Energy flows pretty well. Now understand you're having a tooth problem up here.
Right there.
Yeah, okay. Now let's see where you are. See how weak you get. Okay. So what we're detecting is there's blocked energy flow. I don't know why yet. I just know that it's blocked. Stay there. Now, let's take one of my homeopathic products.
Now, these are your products
that
you developed,
Wolfe's
right?
Toothache product. See the difference? See that restores energy flow.
I'm trying. I'm not playing yet.
Exactly. Go ahead and touch your tooth again. Now, see, without that, the energy's not balanced. Stay there. Touch the tooth. Now, that makes it stronger, too. Keep your hand there. See, when I take it away, you get weak. Now, this is the homeopathic detox. This is for the components of mercury amalgam fillings and just heavy metals in our environment, plus a little lymphatic drainage. So either one of these would be very good for you to take because that tooth has a mercury filling in it. I understand it probably also has some decay under the mercury filling.
Yeah.
So I'm treating both the toothache and the detox until you can go to your dentist and get it fixed.
All right. Thank you.
Well, you're welcome. While you're standing here, let me show you something else. This is a good way to test any product that you buy. Your thymus right here, take your hand, right underneath your sternum. The thymus converts lymphocytes to T lymphocytes, T4s, T8s, immune system. So if your energy is down a little bit today, stay there. We need to keep our thymus healthy. And so, okay, stay there. This is a product that I make. It's the body therapy gel, and it's programmed with frequencies. So when these frequencies come into your frequency field, your aura, your electromagnetic field, let's see what happens. Just stay there. Okay. You feel it gets strong?
Yeah.
See, without it, you're out here. You think that might help you?
That's amazing. I know about energy stuff, yeah. And it's quite
that's yours.
Amazing.
You need it.
Thank you. Thank you.
Rub that on your... face out here, and it'll stimulate the meridians too.
Rub on my face?
Yeah, for the tooth. Yeah. So we make a whole line of products that are energy infused products with my special frequency formulations.
Mm-hmm.
I guess this turned into an infomercial, but the homeopathies that we make are specific homeopathies for specific dental conditions: headache, toothache, trauma, infection, detox. And then the toothpaste that we make, all of my products have frequency formulations with the process I developed for energy enhancement because pain, inflammation is blocked energy flow classically.
So you probably developed these product line because that wasn't available.
Exactly. Everything I've developed for me. You know, this is why I got into testing people's mercury exposures. That's why I've developed the products, because of energetics. I needed energetic enhancement of products that would assist the body to, through sympathetic resonance, to retune the areas that are energy diminished.
Well, that's true with naturopathic physicians, that there weren't a lot of products available for us. So many of my colleagues have developed companies, small businesses of their own with specialized products. Well, so you have a good product line.
Well, thank you. It's a passion that there's no turning back once you go through the doorway to see that there's a larger expanse of potential healing through healing the mouth, through restoring the energetics of the body. The body heals itself if we can just eliminate some roadblocks.
Oh, yes. We call that removing the obstacles to cure.
Yes.
And that's why I invited you as a holistic biological dentist on my show, because your profession is a very important sister profession to naturopathic physicians.
Well, dentistry is always a piece of the health puzzle. Sometimes it's a huge missing piece.
Oh, absolutely. A huge missing piece.
And that's why I don't really like the word alternative therapy. I like complementary therapy, not instead of, in addition to. So it all fits together. It's another piece to the health puzzle.
Well, we in New Mexico are very lucky to have some holistic biological dentists to go to, like Dr. Wolfe. And there's some other good ones. I've had Dr. Yeva Wright on the show previously.
Exactly.
And we're very lucky. Other people have to travel hundreds of miles to find a good holistic dentist. So Dr. Wolfe is here in Santa Fe, New Mexico, in private practice, and also in Albuquerque, New Mexico, in private practice. And look at the end of the show for contact information, and your website is drwolfe.com.
Right? drwolfe.com.
And if people are interested specifically in your product line, is that on your
website
also?
All there, yes. All my children are on the website. And
okay.
I have a video that I developed on energy medicine and what I'm speaking of when I'm talking about frequency formulas and energetic health care.
Excellent. And we've come to the end of our show. Thank you, Dr. Wolfe, for coming on New Mexico's Naturopathic Medical Show. Please stay tuned for another information-rich show.